Sri Mataji, good morning, everyone. Let's bow down to Sri Mataji, raise our Mother Kundalini and put bandhan. Let us put both hands on the ground. Focus attention on Muladhara. You may place back your both hands on the lap and continue to meditate. We may slowly open our eyes and watch Sri Mataji's talk.
I bow to all the seekers of truth. First of all, we have to know what is the truth. People are seeking, seeking, seeking all over, but they don't know what they are seeking and what should they get after their seeking. This seeking can lead you into many diverse directions. Some of them could be very, very dangerous and absolutely misleading. And many must have also felt that. I'm sure there are many who have found it out, but they think there is no way they can return. The seeking is very simple to understand, that you want to know yourself. All the time we say, I want this, I like this, I that. But who is this I? What is it? Who is this one myself? What am I? Do I know anything about myself? It's very superficial knowledge we have about ourselves. Everybody has said, all the religions have said, you should know yourself. There's no difference on this point. Actually, in all religions, if you go in the essence, there's no difference. According to time, it was a little bit stressed on one point and sometimes on another point. But the fundamental thing is that you have to know yourself. How do you know yourself is the point. People will say, do this, give up everything, give up your family, give up everything, wear this kind of dress, cut your hair or shave your hair and all that nonsense. It's so outward. If you put little bit of your intelligence, you'll see it's all outward. It's so skin deep, it has no meaning. So what has to happen? We talk of a last breakthrough of the evolution. How do you achieve it? When you are evolved up to the state of human beings, we have to know one thing for definite, that there's something missing within us. Otherwise, the world would have been a most beautiful place, the paradise to live in. But something wrong with the human beings, and what is that, is to understand how we have come through evolution. And as human beings, there are so many things of the animal stage lingering within us. The way we talk, the way we try to appraise others, the way we talk to sort of dominate others, the way we want to snatch everything, the way we are only worried about our food, this, that, all this is not really noble human beings' sides. These are all lingering from that animal instinct. All right, we have to accept, because we are human beings, so they are to be there. The thing so much frightening. But also we have one more thing that we think. And we think and think and think and think, knowing of ourselves sometimes. Sometimes we think we should protest for this. Sometimes we feel that we must become very violent. All these things are coming from our human mind. Animals won't be violent for something just for violence sake. They'll be violent, all right, but for their own purpose of killing some animal or something. But here we have groups and groups of people who just enjoy violence. This is another development in the human awareness, I think, that we enjoy destruction of others. But also there is a seeking. This is a sign that people want their evolution. They want to evolve into a better personality, that they want to become something which is complete. Now, how do you achieve it? Now, I must say that we have not achieved our evolution ourselves up to the human level. So, to achieve a higher awareness, there must be some arrangement between us. And that is the arrangement we are not aware of. And that arrangement is that within you is the power, it's your own power to give you this last breakthrough through the awakening of that power. Already you have been told about it. It exists, it is there, and it is the right of every human being to get his self-knowledge, self-realization. Sahaja, Saham is born with you. With you is born the right. And why should we not ask under fundamental rights, society, that we should have our self-realization, which is your own. It is there already placed within you. You don't have to do anything. Of course you can't pay for it. How much did you pay for your evolution so far? And how can it be different from different people? Because in every human being this power, which we call as Kundalini, exists, whether he is white, black, yellow, blue, any color, whether he belongs to north or south, any place, whether he belongs to this country or that country, they all have this power universally placed in their Kundalini. Even if I say everybody has a heart, so why should you have differentiation? But this mind, this human mind creates this differentiation and this problem, saying that of course they are not of our country, they don't belong to a group. And like animals again we start getting into groups. Groups of different, I don't know, denomination. Like some people have their fork and spoon put this way, so they are one group. Some people drink coffee, so they have a group like that, you see. We are very good at forming groups. This is also animal instinct, I think, that we try to form groups of such stupid things. And then we can have wars, because we must fight. We are a group, something great, so we should fight others. All these instincts that are between us are inherent. They have come to us. They say it is in our genes. Still, can we change the genes? Can we transform our personality into something higher? And for that I tell you, there is a power within us. All of you have that power within you. And what does it give you? It passes through six centers, as told to you. It nourishes it. Integrates it, and ultimately it pierces through the last fontanelle bone area. We can call the actualization of the baptism, and is connected to the all-pervading power of divine love. Again I say love, divine compassion and divine love. So you get connected to that power which is all-pervading. If you ask a doctor who runs our heart, he'll say, it's the autonomous nervous system. But who is the auto? Who does all these things? Who does all the living works? Look at these flowers, beautiful. Who has made these flowers? It's different flowers. How does this Mother Earth differentiate and how she gives all these flowers? Do we think about it? We take it for granted. All living work we take it for granted, but it is done by this divine power. Believe me, there is this divine power around us, which protects us, which looks after us, which guides us, and also, above all, it loves us and it cares for us. It wants that we should all receive the blessings of this all-pervading power. But if you are not connected, how can you? For example, this instrument is not connected to the mains, it is useless, it won't work. So we all have to be connected with that all-pervading power. This is one thing if we understand. You can also know that you are quite capable of getting to it. There's no outer thing you have to do, like giving up this, giving that, or praying, or nothing of the kind. It is there, this process, living process works, and you get your self-realization. Only thing is that if you have to enlighten, then you have to be enlightened. Like a candle which is not enlightened cannot enlighten any other candle. But one candle which is enlightened can enlighten so many candles. In the same way, you get the power to enlighten so many people all over the world. And not only that, but you get so many powers. But the greatest power is that of compassion and love, by which you care, by which you help people. Luckily, now in your country itself, on the medical institutions have accepted Sahaja Yoga, that it works. Because it attacks, or we should say, it nourishes the centers, basic centers in our body. Now these centers are responsible for our physical, mental, emotional, and also the spiritual being. And it enlightens it, and with that enlightenment you get definitely cured. It's a fact. With Sahaja Yoga many people have been cured. We also have a hospital in India, and we are going to have another hospital there. Maybe in America also we might have a hospital, where you don't have to pay for it, because it is your own power. You may pay for your food or something, but for treatment, what can you pay when it's your own? And this is what is going to tell people how powerful you are. Otherwise, some are extremely aggressive and some are extremely depressive. There's nothing in between. But with this power, you become so much full of compassion. Then your attention goes from you to others. What you can do for others? How can you give them realization? And suddenly you discover that around you is so many destructive forces, so many disturbing forces, so many problems, suddenly you find they disappear. If you can transform human being, but it's no question of transformation, I would say it is the question of evolutionary process. And when this takes place, you find you are transformed completely, and thousands have to be transformed. Thousands and thousands and millions and millions. But somehow America has a different type of approach to spirituality. They think if I don't take money, then something wrong with me. I must accept money. And they have told me so many things. Some experts came and told me, explained to me all the economics and all that which I don't understand. And they think that it should be sellable. Can't understand this kind of a thing. How much will you pay for Christ? How much will you pay for any saintly personality? Because its value cannot be judged. It's invaluable. Something that's the most invaluable for you is to know yourself. If you have not known yourself, you are still going round and round and round in the mad rush of thinking. Even Einstein, you'll be surprised, has talked about it, that he was trying to find the theory of relativity and just he couldn't find it. So he went into his garden and was playing with the soap bubbles, and suddenly from somewhere unknown, that's what he said, the theory of relativity dawned upon him. And he called that unknown area, he called them by a name, you see. And that name is rather, to me, not so precise. But he says there is an area which you can exploit, by which you can understand for the future generation, for the future scientist. Where do you get the ideas from there? And he said, for that you must have a kind of a personality that can perceive that torsion area from where the ideas are coming. If he can enter into that area, you can get the full idea as to what is reality. He calls it cognitive. He says this is cognitive science. And such a person can tell you so many things which, when you put it to the scientific test, you'll find is absolutely correct. And this is what happened to him, because himself was a realized soul. In many people, like Newton himself was a realized soul. Abraham Lincoln was a realized soul. But they could not tell about it to others, because nobody would believe, and anybody tried to tell anything, they just used to torture them. Every saint, real saint, I mean, has been tortured. Every Sufi has been tortured. In our country especially, many saints have been very badly treated. Also in other countries. Why? Because they are only one, and maybe people were jealous that how could they know so much, how could they talk about so many things. Now, with all this, now, only thing if I have done anything is very simple, that I thought no use giving this realization to one or two persons, which was the tradition, to give to only one to one. But now I felt it won't work out. We have to have it for the masses. And I just, what I did was to find out a method by which I can give a mass realization. That's all. Which is a simple thing. And that is working, and it worked very well. As I said, in America, they just think of, this is another achievement of human beings, that they know about money. So money, 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 everything money. So they can't understand even spirituality without money. But in a place like, say, we can say Russia. Russian people had no freedom as you have. And they had oppression from all sides in their, as you know, the whole thing was a communistic country. And in that communism, they were completely oppressed. So as a result, they went inside themselves and tried to find out solutions inside. So when they saw me, just seeing me, I don't know how, thousands of them came. Now we are thousands and thousands and thousands of people in Russia alone, also in other some countries. I mean, when I see here, I'm just thinking in Russia we have to take, we cannot put it in a hall, we have to have a big tent or Olympics where they had some sort of a thing like that. So the trouble is, we should give up this idea that I can find it for myself. This is very, very common. You cannot. This is the only evolution in which you have to get it from an enlightened person. You have to humble on this point, that I can't get it on my own. I can find my own way. You cannot. You'll be lost. You have to have somebody who is already enlightened. Now, how to get an enlightened person also? How to know? Because after realization you know the absolute truth. On your fingertips you can feel the centers of other person. If something is fishy, you can feel it. If somebody is cheating, you can feel it. Everything. Your fingers speak. This is what Muhammad Sahib has said. At the time of resurrection, your hands will speak clearly. How can hands speak? This is how, because all these five fingers are the centers, sixth and seventh center. One on the physical side, another on the physical and also mental side is the right side, and the emotional side on the left side. These are two different systems within us which people are not understanding, that there are two channels within us, what we call as the autonomous nervous system has got parasympathetic nervous system in the center, but there are two left and right sympathetic nervous systems, and these are the system, two systems that are enlightened on your fingertips, by which you know exactly what is wrong with you, what centers you are catching, that is self-knowledge. People will go mad, but they will not know they are getting mad. They will have cancer, they will not know they are having cancer. This indication tells you exactly what's wrong with you. Now, if you know how to correct your centers, you can correct the centers of others also. Then also, this another achievement is that you become collectively conscious. Means you can feel others on your fingertips. You can feel others on your fingertips. Who is the other? That's what we think. But nobody is the other. We are part and parcel of one spiritual personality. And once somebody has problem, we immediately know there's a problem. Because on the fingertips you can feel it. This is true knowledge. Is not some sort of reading a book or some sort of a thing, but is a true knowledge within yourself, which you know yourself, which we call as cognitive science, which works within yourself. You don't have to go out to read anything, to understand anything. Your own being itself is a complete computer, I should say, which tells you what's what, who is what. We have no idea as to what we are. We have not been given any idea as to what potential we have. It's tremendous, it is. It is tremendous, and if it works, it will work for you, for your family, for your children, for your city, for your nation, and for the whole world. So this has to become a collective understanding within yourself, not mentally. Mental understanding is just temporary and passes on. But it's an actualization, again and again I say, it's the actualization of the knowledge within yourself. Then they talk only of that. They talk in the words of chakras, of the centers. That person is this, that person has got this, I have got this. Now, people on your fingertips, which gives you a perfect answer for everything. Then it looks after you, it protects you, it guides you, as I told you, and guides you in the right way, in the right way, manner. And how it achieves things is wonderful. So we have to first and foremost understand that we have to have that special personality of a self-realized personality, which will really help and care for others. It's not just talking, it's not just reading, it's not just following some false guru, but it is following yourself, which is to show that you are your own master. You become your master and you know everything about everything. This is the potential in all of you. As I said, it is not only for few people, it's not for only black-white people, but it's also meant for people who are uneducated, who are living in the villages, who are very simple people. It works for all of them, and when it works, you'll be amazed how it transforms you and transforms others. And you become so confident about yourself. You don't doubt yourself, because there's an absolute knowledge on your fingertips. It is something that is within you which you should achieve. Of course, for this you should know that so far you have not known, so you have to know. As long as you have this attitude, it would work out. I cannot force, Sahaja Yoga cannot force on anyone self-realization. It cannot be forced. It has to be asked for. Unless and until you knock the door, it won't work out. It works out for people only who really want it and who want to become self-realized. As a result, you don't have any responsibilities. It's only the responsibility of the all-pervading power that does everything for you, that looks after you, that guides you and takes you to the right places, to the right situations, and guides you in such a manner that you are amazed. How is it? How is it working? How is it working out? There will be no meaning left to any miracles. But these miracles are not like taking out a diamond and thing like that. But it's a miracle how the circumstances will change, how people will change, how you'll become such a joyous, lovable personality. On this subject, I don't know how many lectures I've given, and there's no end to it. But I would say that you should take your realization and go into our programs, whatever they have, and grow into it. Because you take some time to grow, like a seed sprouts, but it takes time to become a tree. But hardly 1 month at the most. And don't have to pay there also, again I'll tell you. Nothing has to be paid, you just give some time to yourself and it will work out. When you have mastered it, you'll be amazed what you can do, a month at the most. Some people just get it and they don't have to do anything, just they know. But most of the people have to do it. It improves everything, your thinking capacity, in the sense your brains get enlightened. You become a very large-hearted personality. And other things that we think of prosperity and all that, all comes through. This I'm just telling you, like a mother would like to give a castor oil with little chocolate on top. But main thing is you must know yourself how great you are. That is what every mother wants her child to know. That's my only desire, is in America if it spreads. In that manner it will all be a great thing, a great boon for the whole world. May God bless you. Thank you.
Let's continue to meditate.
Thank you.
Slowly open our eyes. Let's collectively raise Kundalini and put ourselves in Bandhan. Sri Mataji. Thank you everyone for joining the Morning Collective.